there. This is Katie Corbett, and I am from Health, Wellness, and Chocolate. And so if you're watching this, I am giving you this class. It's called the Stop Overeating Workshop, how to feel in control around food and how to stop overeating. And this is me. I am Katie Corbett, and I am going to walk you through this. So in this workshop, I want to show you how you can make the ultimate shift from struggling to lose weight and feeling deprived and obsessing about food to changing your desire for food so that you can stop overeating and begin to lose weight for the last time. Okay, so let's make this count, right? Turn off all distractions, because what I teach you actually will really, really help you, especially if you're someone who has yo-yo dieted for decades and maybe weight loss feels super elusive to you, or maybe you know how to lose weight, but then you gain it back, right? As soon as you stop trying or counting every single calorie. So I want you to learn this information because I do think it will help you shift when it comes to hitting those goals that you set for yourself. So if you're here, maybe you feel like, I have tried every diet out there, and maybe you do have some success, like I said, but eventually something happens and then the weight creeps back on. Or, maybe food is an all or nothing proposition for you, right? You're either dieting and starving, or you're eating everything in sight and binging. Or you even think I don't want to lose weight to look hot. I kind of joke, I'm 44 and I'm like, you know what? That teen model ship has sailed. I don't need to be a teen model. I don't need to look hot in a bikini. I've had 8 children, right? I just want to lose weight so I can feel healthy, be a good example for my kids, and really just feel comfortable in my own skin without feeling like I have to starve myself or do hours and hours of boot camp, right? That's kind of how I feel about this whole thing. Well, let me introduce myself. I am a certified health education specialist. I'm also a wellness and health coach, and I specialize in weight loss. I have a master's degree in community health education, and so I developed this program after struggling with my own weight for over 30 years. After I had my 7th baby, I decided the thought of another diet would literally felt like death. I was like, that's it. I cannot do another diet. So I gave myself what I call this year of grace. I stopped dieting, and I just started researching to understand the psychology that went behind weight loss, okay? And then once I started learning and then applying the research that I found to my life, the weight actually began to come off. I lost 60 pounds in 5 years later. I turned that journey into a course so I can help other women lose weight for the last time and go from feeling powerless around food to being empowered and having peace with food without needing a crazy eating plan or some insane exercise routine. I'm also a homeschool mom. Like I said, I have 8 children. I have been married for 20 years to my husband, Chris. So what I want you to do is imagine being able to put on your favorite pair of jeans and just feel great in them, right? No drama, just put them on. Or you can go out to dinner with friends and not obsess over what to order. Am I going to blow my diet? Am I, we shouldn't even be here. Let's not even make plans with friends, right? Imagine no longer really having to worry about what you're eating. Food is no longer the center of your life, and you're not constantly obsessing about the thought oh my goodness, I need to lose weight, or what diet should I start on Monday? Those are no longer necessary. So what I want to teach you in this class is the real reason why you overeat, and I'm going to help you change your desire for food. And it's not going to require willpower on your part. And if you like what I teach you and you want to find out how to get more help, I'll tell you how you can work with me in the future if you think that is something that you want to do. So the first strategy I want to talk about is kind of this idea of training your brain, also brain hacks. And really what this takes is just understanding the neuroscience of willpower, right? And like I said, this isn't going to take willpower. I want you to understand how your brain works so that you don't need is willpower, okay? So you have 2 regions of your brain. You have this prefrontal cortex and you have this limbic system. Now, your brain is hardwired. It wants to, right, it was designed to seek pleasure, right, to make sure you stay happy, avoid pain, keep you safe, and it creates habits so that it doesn't use up a lot of energy, because your brain uses a huge amount of energy. So what it does is it automates as much as it possibly can. So when you start to do things over and over and over again without even really trying, You build a habit and your brain's like, oh, I know how to do that. I'll just do what always works. And we're just going to do that over and over again. And then I don't have to think about it, right? So your brain wants you happy. It wants you safe. And it doesn't really want to think about how to do that. It wants to just fall back on old patterns. And it doesn't want you to feel uncomfortable. It doesn't want you to have any pain. It just wants you happy. Okay. And that's really nice. But it doesn't really help in a world where there's an abundance of food all the time. Like, that strategy was awesome, maybe when food was more scarce, but now it's not so helpful, okay? So I'm going to teach you some tools that you can override that natural tendency of your brain to help it work for you so that it serves you instead of you feeling like you're always at the mercy of the urges that you have when it comes to food. So why do we overconsume? A lot of times, especially if you're a yo-yo dieter, you tend to overconsume really out of habit or out of that desire to just feel good, right? Like, we'll overconsume because it's just like what feels good. Our brain has learned that in order to feel better or overconsume, it helps us stay out of pain, okay? So it also, you have to also pay attention to your eating habit loop. So really what happens is when you overconsume, your brain, and I learned this from Dr. Roger Gould, he basically said, you know, you have two stomachs. You have one stomach that is called like the phantom stomach, and then you have your actual biological stomach. Well, your brain, especially if you have yo-yo dieted, your brain has kind of fused the two stomachs together, and anything that comes up from either stomach will register inside your brain as feeling hungry. So if you have an emotional event or a trigger, or you just associate any uncomfortable feeling, your brain says, hey, I know how to make you feel better. I'm going to tell you you're hungry so that you'll go get some food, and that hit of dopamine will make you feel better, but also it will distract you from whatever uncomfortable feeling you're having right now. Okay, so your brain will take any kind of event that's unpleasant or uncomfortable, and it's going to just let you know you're hungry. And here's the thing, you actually will feel hungry, right? Your brain is that powerful. So if you don't understand this, you'll say to yourself, but I actually am hungry. I hear my stomach growling, right? But that is actually called phantom hunger. And really, your brain just associates all feelings with a desire to eat. So it could be joy, it could be sadness, it could be stress, it could be overwhelm, it could be happy feelings, right? But our brain has learned, hey, this is how Katie knows how, how to feel better. I know how to make her feel better. I'm just going to go tell her to eat. Or, hey, it's a party. Yeah, that's what we eat when it's party time. So yeah, same thing. Katie, just go eat, right? So we can eat and overeat and overconsume more than our body needs just as a response to a trigger event. Because again, our brain will just automate as much as it possibly can. There's also this idea of scarcity or black and white thinking or all or nothing thinking. We might overconsume because we'll think, oh, you know what? I just had that cupcake or that donut at work because they were there, and now I just blew the whole diet. I'll just start over again on Monday. And so you just wind up overconsuming the whole weekend because you have this scarcity mindset where, I'll eat this now because I know the diet's going to start Monday and I'll just get in as much as I can right now. Or you think, just this one thing won't hurt. This won't matter. Just this one little bite, right? Like all the things we that tell ourselves, okay? So your job, and now that you know this information and you know how your brain works, your job is to pay attention to that eating habit loop and pay attention to your eating triggers. So if you go throughout the week, when you're done watching this and you go through the week, start to notice, hey, wait a second. I noticed, you know what? I overconsume on these days, and it's usually because I'm really stressed out or I'm doing this or that, and I didn't notice. I always just thought I was hungrier on those days, but hey, guess what? I'm not. It's just because, it's a habit my brain was telling me. So that is something that you definitely want to pay attention to. The good news is stopping overeating is really actually pretty simple, right? Like, just stop overeating. The harder part is to understand how to learn what those eating triggers are and what the habit loop is that has gotten you into the practice of overconsuming. Okay, so one way to identify your habit loop and the triggers that actually start to get you to overconsume are these questions, right? And you can jot these down. So you want to ask yourself, okay, where am I? Is it a specific time of day? So what time is it? How do I feel? Who else is around? And what were you doing just before the desire to eat struck? Okay, this can really help you. And I'll give you two quick examples. One has to do with time of day. For me, having 8 kids, by 4 o'clock in the afternoon, the house just gets louder. I don't know what it is, but like the volume here gets turned up, right? And so by 4 o'clock in the afternoon, things get a little hairy around here. And my habit was like, I would start to feel stressed or overwhelmed. And my brain just assumed like, hey, you know what? Good moms don't feel stressed or overwhelmed. You must be not a good mom because you feel stressed and overwhelmed. And so my response to feeling like bad or guilty, my brain was like, but you know what? Why don't you go eat a handful of chocolate chips? You'll feel much better. And so at 4 o'clock every day, I got into this habit of going and reaching for a handful of chocolate chips. It was a great distraction. It was a great hit of dopamine, and it really was just a habit. I didn't even notice I was doing it after a while. It was just like, ooh, you know, I get to have some chocolate chips right now. And it's just like what I did. So once I noticed it, I was like, well, what else can I do at that time of day that would help me feel better? And I planned it out, and I said, you know what? Instead of going for those chocolate chips, I'm going to go and walk around outside. I'll take the kids out. They can blow off energy. I'll walk around my driveway, and I'll get some energy and stress out and decompress a bit. And maybe I'll put on a great podcast that I like. And that strategy worked wonders for me. Okay. And then another one was my brain had gotten into that habit of telling me I was hungry every time I pulled up the driveway. And it just was born out of the idea of like, whenever we were out and about and we came home, I would always feed the kids. So my brain just automated like pulling up the driveway, it was time to eat. And it would tell me I was hungry. And I would believe it because I didn't understand the neuroscience behind this. So I'd pull up the driveway and we'd head inside and eat something. And so the one morning after I learned this, I ran to the post. We had breakfast and I ran to the post office to drop off the mail. And I came, I pulled back up the driveway, and it was only like 8:30 in the morning, and we had just eaten. And my brain, literally, I heard my brain say, it's time to eat. And then I understood what it was doing. I'm like, it is not time to eat. I actually like was able to kind of catch that thought and be like, no way, it is not time to eat. What are you doing? This is not when we eat. And immediately that hunger feeling subsided. And it was right then, that moment, I knew like, oh my goodness, I am onto something, because I am going to challenge every time my brain tells me it's time to eat, because I don't really think it is time to eat when it's telling me. And it was finally, I gave myself permission to question that. And that was really a game changer for me. So find out, like, where are you when you have these sudden urges to eat? What time of day is it? How do you feel? Who's around? Maybe there's like a person you find really aggravating, you know, that like you want to eat because they make you annoyed, and like eating just feels better than being with that person. Or maybe they make you feel really good and it's fun being with them. And so it's like eating is fun and you want to eat more when you're with this person, right? It doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be a negative experience, but just start paying attention to that. Okay, so the second strategy is what I want you to do is start choosing what you want to eat 24 hours ahead of time and start writing it down inside your journal. So get a little food journal and just start jotting down what everything you're going to eat tomorrow, and keep your future person in mind when you're writing it. So when you start to consider like who you are, who you want to be, and you want to start eating well, because chances are, if you're watching this, you probably have yo-yo dieted on and off. So I'm sure you know all the food rules already. So planning what you want to eat that like is nourishing, that you enjoy eating, that you know is totally doable, write it down. And then the challenge actually is sticking to what you have told yourself you were going to do, okay? And what happens is there's actually some brain research that I have that backs this up. But what you're really doing essentially is you're forcing a neural pathway to your prefrontal cortex. So your basically hacking your brain to create this new habit. Because your limbic system is the reactionary part of your brain. It's the part of your brain that really, I kind of call him like the Jake Peralta. He just does what feels good. He just wants to he just reacts to the circumstances around him, right? Well, your prefrontal cortex is the part of your brain that is in charge of planning. She's like the Amy Santiago character, right? Like, she's the planner. She's always thinking of the future and what is the best move, right? Like, that part of your brain is what you use then when you're planning ahead of time. So it keeps your goals in mind. It keeps your values in mind. And that's what you want to use when you're trying to hit your goals, right? So you're going to plan 24 hours ahead of time so that you're not reacting to the urgency or whatever is coming up inside your brain. And you're teaching your brain hey, you know what? I am in control. You are not in control. I don't have to act on every single thought I have, especially when it comes to hunger, and especially if it's not going to serve me. Okay, so you're going to begin to train your brain, and we call it surfing the urge. And this was actually based on a really great study that was done at Princeton University using smoking. And they found this was better than any smoking cessation workshop that was done up to this point. And of course, changing habits and breaking hard habits up, especially when it comes to some urges and desires, this tool you'll find really, really helpful. So basically what your brain starts to do, say you have an urge or a craving to eat something, right? You pull up your driveway and your brain's now it's time to eat, okay? And you have this really, really huge desire to eat. Well, what your brain does is something called an elaborated intrusion theory. You might think of something to eat, but then your brain's doesn't that sound good? Oh, and what about this? And you envision it. And the more details you get, so you're thinking of ice cream and then how it started to melt and get a little drippy and, all these things. It's your brain will elaborate and it will constantly push into your thoughts this elaborated intrusion, right? This over ridiculous, it's almost marketing really inside your brain, okay? But you can't control if your brain is doing this to you. You can't control the cravings. They are just going to happen. But what you can do is once you start to have a craving, you'll start to imagine that food in more and more detail. So what you have to do is you can just kind of cut it off or short circuit it and be that's just a thought, right? And really, if you even just say that sentence, that's just a thought. Studies have shown that saying that helps you cope better with this elaborated intrusion theory. So if you find food is always calling you from the other room, you don't have to answer it. You could just be that's just a thought. Okay. That's a really easy tool to use. So what you want to do when you surf the urge is you're going to notice the craving that you're having, right? So pay attention to it. Oh man, why do I suddenly want chocolate? Or why do I suddenly desire hot French fries? Or whatever your thing is, right? Notice the craving. And you can, instead of beating yourself up and saying oh man, I have no willpower, why am I such a loser? All the terrible things we say to ourselves, just accept it. Yeah, I see that. I see that. Those fries are really tasty. I can understand why my brain wants fries right now, right? You don't have to beat yourself up. You can just accept yeah, I see. I have a craving right now. But don't act on it, okay? Just sit there and sit with it. And then give yourself time to decide what best response will work for you. Okay? And doing this will help increase what's called your emotional intelligence. So really, if you know all the eating rules, but you still struggle with your weight, your emotional intelligence is probably a piece of the puzzle that has been missing for you. Because studies have shown that people who have struggles with their weight actually score very low on emotional intelligence. Because usually we will just not understand our thoughts or our feelings. And we think that our brain is reporting the truth to us, and so we'll just act on them. But I want to give you this third strategy, which will help you build emotional intelligence, and I call it my splashes of joy jar. So you can see in the picture, it's just a jar. It's just a clear glass jar, and then I got these beads from just Michael's craft store. Mine are flat, but you can use anything you want, really. And what you're going to do is, so you've gotten your little beads or your marbles, and you've gotten your splash of joy jar. And when you have a craving, rather than answer it and respond to it by eating, I want you to sit with it, and they call it ride the wave. Okay, so you're gonna just sit with it and pay attention to it. Be like, huh, yeah, I want fries. I wonder why. You know, and just don't judge yourself. Don't be like, well, you know, you're such a loser. Why do you want fries? You know, no wonder you can't lose weight, right? Don't even beat yourself up. Just be like, yeah, fries would be nice right now, but I don't need to do that, right? And what this is called riding the wave. And then every 10 minutes, what you're gonna do is add a splash of joy to your joy jar. This what happens is by the time you reach 100 splashes of joy, you have trained your brain to not just react to every single craving it has, right? It puts you in the driver's seat of not having to answer your brain's cravings, which is a huge, huge deal, especially when it comes to weight loss. And this doesn't require willpower, right? It's just sitting there and just saying, I don't need to have that right now. I wonder why I want it so bad. Okay? And every 10 minutes, just give yourself a splash of joy. And now what happens is after those splashes of joy, you have created a new neural pathway inside your brain that will allow you, it's almost like a muscle where, you know, your brain may make a suggestion and you can very easily say, no, I don't need to answer that right now. Okay? So you have grown this like mental muscle of being able to not answer these urges that you have, but also these splashes of joy, this 100 splashes of joy inside that jar, they now represent food that you did not eat, which is pretty amazing, right? Think of all those calories that that splash of joy jar represents. Definitely a few pounds at the least, okay? And by doing this, you're just breaking that habit loop that your brain created to respond with the event with the desire to eat. And remember back at the beginning of this, I said, you know, your brain will have some trigger. It could be happiness, sadness. It could be a positive emotion or a negative one, but your brain will automate it and be like, hey, let's go eat, right? So really what you're doing is you're, without using willpower, you've created a new neural pathway and breaking that habit loop up. So your brain will learn a new way to respond to a thought or a new way to that serves you rather than telling you you're hungry. So if it is an unpleasant emotion, your brain might say, hey, you should go outside, or hey, why don't you go to sleep? You're probably tired, right? Like it will come up with a better solution that serves you with your health and wellness, as opposed to just saying, hey, you're probably hungry, you should go eat something, right? And so you're hacking your brain, right? Like you're creating those neural pathways that serve you, your unique personality and your unique likes and dislikes, right? The strategies that you come up with besides eating will really serve you specifically. Okay, so do you really see how all this works together? You begin to notice patterns with your eating habits, and then you understand how your brain works to keep you happy and as unburdened as possible, right? It just wants a good time. It wants to keep you safe. It wants to keep you happy. It does not want you to have to think too much or worry too much, right? Anything unpleasant, it's just going to have you, it's just going to have you go eat, right? So you're going to use surfing the urge and sit with those cravings as opposed to answering them with food, because by doing that, you are building that new neural pathway in your brain. And then concrete these new habits into your mind by giving yourself that splash of joy every 10 minutes. And then by following these steps and bringing awareness and understanding to my own eating habits, I was able to lose 8 pounds the very first week I implemented this. And remember when I said I'd come up my driveway and my brain would be like, it's time to go eat. When I finally noticed this and actually started doing this, like, wait, it is not time to go eat. And I really wasn't even craving anything. My brain was just like, you're hungry, you should go eat something. It was just triggered by an action of a location. I actually lost 8 pounds the first week of starting to challenge my brain. Like, I don't really think I'm hungry. Okay. And this was, I didn't feel deprivation. I wasn't hungry. I really wasn't hungry, because as soon as I challenged my brain, I was like, I don't think this is accurate. I really don't think I'm hungry. That I lost 8 pounds, and I had not done that ever in my entire life. Right. So this was a new way of relating to food. And so I know if you take these tools that I teach you, even just these few that I've taught you right now, you will definitely be well on your way to starting to get into the hit the goals that you want to get to. So if you're still watching this, I'm assuming you have probably tried every diet out there and you may have had some success, but eventually something happens in life, right? Life happens, and the weight tends to just creep back on. Because remember, your brain just wants to do what it knows what to do. You haven't really changed any of the habits or changed any of those neural pathways. You've just been following a diet. And as soon as life gets in the way, the diet's out the window and your brain is just going to go right back to default. Okay. Now, food may be an all or nothing proposition for you. Like you're either dieting and starving or you're eating everything in sight and binging, right? You're kind of still stuck in that scarcity or that black and white thinking. And like I said, like you might not even want to lose weight to look hot, right? You just want to lose weight to feel healthy or be a good example for your kids or walk down the aisle at your child's wedding or play with the grandkids. Like the teen modelship has sailed. You really just want to be healthy for health's sake. And you're really maybe feeling defeated. Like this feels so elusive or you just feel so powerless. So you really have two options, right? You can continue doing what you've always done. You can continue yo-yo dieting. You can continue searching for that next promising diet, the one, I know this one will work. I know this is the right way or whatever. Let me try this new diet. I heard so-and-so is doing really well on it. And then, you know, you're always on the search for the next best thing, right? Or you have a second option, and this is the option that I hope you would like to choose, and that is to follow a proven roadmap. So I wanted to invite you, I created the Health and Wellness Blueprint based on the research that I did, and now I have helped a ton of women through the Health and Wellness Blueprint. I help you lose weight for the last time. And there is just a quick glimpse of what I offer inside the Health and Wellness Blueprint. Okay, so in there, you're going to learn how to apply the tools I teach so you can increase your emotional intelligence, so you understand the why behind the struggle with your weight. You'll be able to distinguish between those two stomachs. Remember, I taught you about that, so we'll go into a deeper dive with that, and you'll learn how to properly nourish your body and stop overeating naturally. You'll learn how to stop living in extremes of eating perfectly on a diet or eating everything in sight. And I always say extra weight is really just a symptom of a life out of balance, and diets are really just band-aids. So we're going to get to the root cause of why you battle with your weight so that you never have to yo-yo diet again. And really what you'll start doing then is really creating and building a life you love based on your unique personality. So food is no longer the center of your world or like the best part of your day. And you'll begin to understand your thoughts and how they affect your behavior and your appetite so that cravings are no longer an issue. And you'll learn state-of-the-art coping tools for stress and anxiety so you're no longer stress eating or hitting the drive-through on your way home after a rough day. You'll learn how to identify your unique strengths and you'll leverage them for weight loss success. So losing weight isn't even really difficult. We're going to build on what you have right within you. And for the first time in your life, you'll finally be able to understand your appetite and that drive to eat. And so you'll understand, like, why was weight loss so elusive for me? And I'll help you pick that apart and really get that. And really, you'll begin to understand how your brain has learned to relate to food so you never feel powerless or chaotic around food again, which is so huge. So inside the Health and Wellness Blueprint, you'll learn to identify what you're hungry for. You'll learn like the meta skills on how to shift your mindset around your body and food. And then I even have advanced weight loss concepts for your success. Inside the Health and Wellness Blueprint, right when you sign up, you'll get immediately 9 foundational weight loss modules, 12 weeks of advanced weight loss trainings. Plus, we'll meet weekly every Monday at 10 a.m. for 12 weeks where you can ask me questions, and I usually go deeper on one of the topics inside the Health and Wellness Blueprint, and you will have access to the replay if you can't make it live. And you actually do have lifetime access to the Health and Wellness Blueprint. So once you join, you can participate in any of our weight loss challenges as they come up. So this isn't a membership. You buy it and you have it for the lifetime of the course. So you won't lose access to it. So you don't have to feel like, oh my gosh, I'm in a hurry. I only have 12 weeks, but I have a lot of weight to lose. You have access to this forever. And actually, the live question and answer, you can ask me questions anytime. I'm the owner. I created the Health and Wellness Blueprint, so it is me. And if you have questions, you can just email me and I'm right here. Like, you are fully supported in this whole journey that you have. And then this is from Terry, who is my client inside the Health and Wellness Blueprint. She said, I bought the blueprint and this has given me hope and more confidence that I can do this. In the context of a lifetime, my lifetime, this will be the one thing. As I'm doing most of the other healthy habits, this will improve my quality of life and reduce my risk factors for chronic conditions. Thank you, Katie. Keep up the great work. And she's doing amazing inside the blueprint. So this is what you get when you sign up. You get 9 modules, which are foundational trainings, similar to this, but we expand on a lot of the concepts. And so you'll have tools to use. You'll have a workbook that you get to download. The modules are not very long, and this isn't going to take a ton of your time. But if you are really kind of spinning your wheels or super frustrated, I guarantee that this is the missing piece of the puzzle that you have been looking for when it comes to improving your health and losing weight. And then again, there's 12 advanced weight loss trainings. And we will meet weekly for live questions and answers, and I'll be able to answer all your questions and guide you every step of the way. I've also included my first bonus, which is How to Eat Like Your Skinny Friends ebook, which you'll have immediate access to. And listen, I am not special, right? Like, I'm a homeschool mom. I have 8 kids. I'm super busy too, but I really felt like I could not stomach literally the idea of another diet. And I said, if I can figure this out, I have an obligation to teach other women this, because there is nothing worse than going to bed every night feeling like a failure or feeling powerless to be able to finally get a hold of weight and just start living life instead of hiding behind fat. You know, like, it just really bothered me. I just wanted to feel comfortable in my own skin. And I was so sick of just trying different diet plans and failing at them, right? So finally, I just researched what I was missing in this weight loss process, and I found success. And I just want to share that wisdom with you so that you can also just start losing weight for the last time. So I wanted to spoil you. I love to spoil the ladies inside my program. So not only do you get the How to Eat Like Your Skinny Friends ebook, but I also included these other bonuses. You get a self-care 101 mini course that has its own printable workbook. You also get another class, How to Manage Stress and Anxiety Without Using Food or Alcohol mini class, and then also How to Understand Prediabetes and hormones as well. And listen, I do have a money-back guarantee because I want you to be happy. I do believe like this is an awesome program and you will have success if you do it. So if you do the work and you show me that you did it within 2 weeks of enrolling, and if you're not satisfied or you're like, no, this isn't really going to work for me, I will be happy to give you a refund. So there really is no risk, right? You also get these bonuses, the ebook, the self-care class, the Managing Stress and Anxiety Without Food class, Understanding Prediabetes and Hormones class. I really tried to throw in as much stuff as I can for you, just to spoil you and encourage you, really take that step and make that investment in yourself, because I feel like this is a game changer. This is what you have been looking for. This missing piece of the puzzle that weight loss has felt so elusive for you. And I feel like it's the psychology, or like I said, like, extra weight is really just because life has been out of balance. We find out where it's out of balance, and then I help you build a life you love. And then food and weight will really just take care of itself. Okay, so it's only $350. I wanted to make it super affordable so that there really was, like, this was a no-brainer. Like, $350, one and done. You know, you have lifetime access to it. You have me, 12 weeks of us meeting together and access to me where you can ask me questions, I can answer them, we can talk live at 10 o'clock every Monday morning, or if you have questions, you can ask me them ahead of time and I can answer them right on our Zoom call. But that was super important for me to make you feel like, you know, you are fully supported. So if $350 all at once doesn't seem possible for you, you can also make 4 payments of $99. That's up to you. And you can go to the website, then the link will be right below this video for you to be able to access that. And I also wanted to do another bonus, right? So this one, this is a fast action bonus. I wanted to include it because I really want you to feel fully supported. I'm going to offer a one-on-one 1 hour or 60 minute coaching session for the first 30 people who join the Health and Wellness Blueprint right now. Now, I have to keep it to 30 people, which is why if you are thinking you want to do this, I encourage you to act fast. This will be going out to probably about 5,000 people. So I don't want you to delay. I think this is important. I think if you're on the fence, just go for it. You will be pleasantly surprised. And like I said, I do offer a 2 week money back guarantee. So if this isn't something that you think will work for you, show me you did the work and I'll be happy to give you your money back. So really there is no risk. And you also get this one-on-one hour-long coaching call where I can help you directly, just you and me. But I really don't have a huge amount of time in my schedule, so I had to cap it at 30 people. So if you wait too long, that bonus will probably go away. So again, it's $350 paid in full or 4 payments of $99. And you can head to the link that is right below this video. And this is what it looks like. I wanted to give you an idea of like, wait, what do I do? So when you click on the link and you go to the website and you can click on buy now, you'll fill in your details, your name. You'll have you create a password and you can confirm your password and then you'll pay. And this is what happens. You'll get sent a confirmation page and it'll say, you did it, you're in, yay. And then go ahead and check your email and it'll tell you, you'll get an email from Health, Wellness, and Chocolate and it'll say, thanks, congratulations for purchasing the Health and Wellness Blueprint. You can log in and it'll give you your email and your password at the link below and it'll send you a login link. So you just click on that and then you sign in to your account that you created with your email and your password. And then there it is. There's the members area. So you go in and you can start immediately watching the lesson. So you have access immediately to this class. So no worries. You can start right away. You can download the workbook right away. You can download the ebook right away. And you can get started on the all the foundational videos immediately. So don't wait. It's 4 payments of $99, or you can pay in full and save $50, and it would only be $350 paid in full. Now you might be saying, oh, I don't want to start another diet. This is not a diet. You get to pick the food you want. I will go into that on the very first video. You get to choose what you're going to eat, and you're going to plan it 24 hours ahead of time, just like I taught you here. So you're in charge of your food, because I know if you're like me, you know all the right foods to eat, okay? And listen, don't be afraid to fail again. Be afraid to not try and still be in the same place you are right now, right? Because years are going to go by and you could have either moved forward and tried different things and really like learned something in this program that's not a diet plan, right? You're going to learn meta skills that are going to teach you how to hit the goals you want. So there's really no failing. You're going to be learning and that's so exciting. So you can either stay stuck or you can move forward and learn new things, right? And again, I am a mom of 8. I don't have a lot of time either. So I made these videos as short and digestible as possible. You don't have to dedicate a lot of time to this. Most of the videos are, you know, 20 minutes, some are 30 minutes, but that's it. And you have lifetime access. So even if you don't have a ton of time right now, and you just watch a couple of the first few videos and get started, you can always come back and watch as you need to and as you go, or start to learn a tool and then move on to the next tool. You don't have to do it all worrying like, oh my goodness, at the end of the month, I'm going to lose access to this. This is not like that. You have lifetime access. So you could pick up right now or you could pick up, you know, in a month from now. But the live Q&A will be starting. So I definitely want you to go ahead and do that, right? So maybe you think, well, I have PCOS or other health issues, which makes losing weight difficult. Like I said, this isn't a diet plan. These are more meta skills for your brain. But I will go into hormones, how to reduce inflammation in your body so that PCOS is also reduced by weight loss and by reducing some of the hormones that contribute to inflammation inside your body, which makes weight loss difficult. So you definitely would serve you. Okay, so to enroll, head over to healthwellnessandchocolate.com And the link is right inside this video. Okay. And then here's two more women too. I wanted to put them all up, but I don't know who to put up there. Everybody in there is really awesome. So Jennifer says, I've been meaning to message you. I wanted to say thank you. Working with you has been an eye-opening experience. I didn't realize how much food baggage I was carrying around. So I had to text you right away. Since Monday, I have been following my body's actual hunger, which is what we teach inside the class, inside the blueprint. And every morning I have such freedom knowing I don't have to feel deprived, or when I'm hungry or guilty. I stepped on the scale this morning just to see, even though it really hasn't been that long. Can you believe it? It went down in pounds, no less. I'm telling you, I have tried everything else, but this is something I will do for life. No more guilt. Thank you so much, Katie. And that's from Angela. So I just want to encourage you, if you are on the fence, go for it. Invest in yourself. You have nothing to lose except maybe some bad habits. But I would love to see you inside the Health and Wellness Blueprint. Okay, and that is it. So doors will be closing May 23rd, so I hope you get in there. We start, our first class is going to be May 24th. So go ahead and get in there. I can't wait to see you. All right, you have a great day. Bye-bye.